Hey survivors, welcome back to Frost Wanderer here. It's been a couple days since I've done any recording. Actually, closer to like a week. I was actually sick for a while, and I just couldn't record. My voice just sounded terrible. I'm still kind of recovering, but I think I'm sound okay now. I'm probably able to record some. So we're over here at the Haddock Cove, and I wanted to kind of explore down through here today and get down to this area, see what's down here. I really need to find some more ammo. I'm really short on 45 ammo right now, and need some water as well. I don't have very much water left, or any at all, really. So, need to find a source of water, some food. I think I've already been over here. And just need to get some of this stuff kind of settled, because, yeah, right now we're just not in the best shape. I'm pretty sure I explored this whole place before. Wait, I'm going north. I want to go south, don't I? I want to go north. Oh, that's the... Okay, I don't want that marker up there. I want the marker to be, like, down here. There we go. So, really appreciate all the comments, all the likes and all the views and everything. You know, you guys watching my stuff really keeps me going. You know, keeps me inspired to keep doing this. I want to play through Far Harbor just for playing through it, but it doesn't hurt that you guys are enjoying it as well. So, and yes, got this lovely infection this morning that I have to deal with still. So that's gonna be a pain, but what can you do, right? Almost tempted to... Oh, you can't... Can you not get in here? Oh, yeah, you can. I was going to say there's stairs in here. There's... Looked like there was stuff in here. I'm going to try to hold on to my bottles if I can. And maybe I'll find a sink that I can fill them at. That'd be nice. Some actual bobby pins. I've got lots of grenades and mines, but I don't have anything else. That's not really ideal. And I swear to God, it's like every day is a radstorm day out here. Which I know Far Harbor does not have the best of weather, but still, it's kind of excessive. Oh my God, he's scary as shit looking. Oh, I can block him. Like some Dark Souls shit right here. Oh God, that's not that bad. Not that bad. Oh God. Oh my God. That hitting it with his head, that really hurt. Oh Jesus. All right, let's try a grenade, maybe, if I can get some distance. Oh, shit. Why am I no longer running? Did that hit him? No, not really. Oh my God. His pathing seems to not like this, Oh, Jesus. Oh, God, I just barely got off that block. His pathing seems to be confused. Shit, that's not gonna hit him. Honestly, I've fought Dark Souls bosses that were easier than this. Okay. So I couldn't block that. All right, guys. Like, this would be the entire episode if I actually killed this guy this way, okay? So I'm just gonna kill him with Vats, if I can. I don't even know if I can kill him with Vats, to be honest, because this guy is ridiculously strong. Like, I don't know. Maybe with a shish kebab, but this is gonna be kinda nuts. Assuming I can sneak up on him. Yeah, alright, so, here we go. Well, that helped quite a lot. But... oh, fuck, no. Nay. Oh, God. Let's try to get something between us, yes? Crap. No! God! Let's try some mines. Yeah? Like... Run! Okay, that did like nothing to him. Oh, Jesus. God, I'm trying... Fuck! Such a big delay when... Oh my God! Jesus Christ, this really is a Dark Souls boss. Oh! Save me, bear! Oh God! Oh God, okay. Okay, I'm gonna drag it. I don't know where the hell I was, though. Where's that bear at? Alright, we're gonna get them to fight. That's what we're gonna do. I think he was over this way. Alright, where is Mr. Bear at? Over here somewhere, yeah? Alright. So we're gonna sneak up on this guy. I'm gonna do everything I can to kill him, but I probably won't be able to. Alright, here goes. Well. Fortifying Shadowed Combat Armor Left Arm. Ooh, shit, that's nice. Plus one strength and endurance. Hell yes. Alright, well. He's dead. Here's a tent, too. Gonna be honest, one-shotting him was kinda overpowered. I mean, I did take drugs, and I did take a hit to sanity, but still, it's kinda OP. So anyway, before our detour there, God, Far Harbor is scary. There is this church over here I want to check out, or whatever. It looked like a church from a distance. I'm not sure if it's actually a church or not. I wonder where that bear is at. Where the hell is the church? I kind of lost sight of it now. Another little settlement over here. I'll check this out first real quick. There are frag mines around here I need to be careful of. Oh, fuck. Got too close to that one. Can I make this, make some bear ribs? I've got crawler meat. need oil for this. Interesting. Increases your damage resistance in foggy and rainy conditions. Alright, I really need some water now. Quite dehydrated after that. After using those drugs. And now I don't know where the hell I am. Oh, here we go. Here's the church. Looks like it is indeed a church. A ruined church. But I have a feeling I'm going to find ghouls in here. Just seems logical for some reason that there would be ghouls in here. I don't know why. Seems that way. So there's some oil. Can now make, can use my paint. Use the oil and the paint to make some fried crawler. Is there anything useful back here? Oh yeah, there we go. Got some water though. I'll take the water for sure. Drink that right away. Doubt there's anything up here, but. Oh, never mind. 50 caliber sniper rifle. I don't think I can just jump off of here. I'm gonna take, you know what, it doesn't matter. Take a little bit of damage, it's fine. I say that and I could have broken my leg there. Be very sorry then. Let's go back towards the kind of southwest here. That bear looked like a really old, like scarred, tough old bear. Kind of want to see if he's over here somewhere. Here's a bed that I cannot use, I guess, because this guy is on it. Bolt action, pipe bolt action rifle. Guess you can't get out that way. Alright, so there's all kinds of stuff over here. Let's take a look around here. Fringe Cove Docks. Got a mute crab. Maybe we'll find some eggs, although I don't really have the dirty water to be spending on eggs right now. I got plenty of other meat, too. Lots of rats out here, that's for sure. The hell we got going on over here? I think I got a couple of stim packs there. So what is the deal with the garden gnome? I don't see him in there. I don't know what happened to him. I picked him up, but it's weird. Garden gnomes are creepy. Probably have enough wonder glue and such now that I could probably make the pocketed armor on the one piece I have left. It's not pocketed, but kinda actually hoping I find something better than this crappy, whatever the armor is called I'm wearing, the Trapper armor. It's not particularly good. I'll definitely swap out a piece for that combat armor as soon as I can. Oh, this kind of, caved in, didn't it? Fringe Cove dot key, alright. Guess that opens up that door over there, I'd assume. There's a bear somewhere. There. If I jump over there, he's gonna have his way with me. It's not gonna be good. God, that accuracy is so bad. Yep, he doesn't care. That's how we do it. Do I bleed a tire iron? There we go. And I tried to run and there we go. Get up there. I apologize to you guys if this is like old stuff to you. But I have not played through all of Far Harbor. When I tried to previously, my game actually bugged out and I couldn't progress through it. And I got frustrated. I never actually got around to playing through all of Far Harbor. And I haven't actually touched Nuka World. That's what I was doing with my other survival playthrough. I was like, well, okay, I'll do like one last survival mode playthrough and I'll get to Nuka World and Far Harbor. I'll play through those and that'll be cool because it's all new stuff to me. Even though survival mode itself, like the vanilla game is kind of boring. So I've done everything already. And then, yeah, like, stuff bugged out, and I got kind of frustrated, and then I saw Frost, and I just, yeah, from there, I kind of got lost in Frost. And so, yeah, I've never actually, it's a bit sad, really. At over 1,000 hours played, I have not been through Far Harbor yet. Boy, that looks cool as hell. Has all collapsed in there. So I don't know the story of Far Harbor. I don't know anything about it. This is all new stuff to me. So if I kind of take the time, you know, take my time to kind of smell the daisies through here, that's why. It's because it's all new to me. So these areas, they look really cool though. Like just their design and everything. How this whole, it takes so much work, you know, to make this like kind of collapsed, fallen over place here. Like, I mean, it would be easier to just make like an actual standing, like dock slash warehouse building than it would be to actually make one that's, you know, all broken up and fallen over and stuff. It takes far more work to do it like that and to make it look believable and everything too. So interestingly, I've heard that we will be getting more ways to reduce sanity come in version 0.4. So that's Nogrim is apparently relenting a little bit with that. I really hope my suggestion for hookers is taken seriously and added in. That would be amazing. Of course, you don't need to take it as far as some of the people in... you can get up there, can't you? So I have to take it as far as some of the people took it in Fallout 3 in New Vegas, where apparently you can just get like hardcore pornography mods that actually lets you have sex with your companions, like full on, everything shown. Like, why is this in a video game? Like, why did somebody create this? Type stuff. So we don't need quite that much, but I'd like to be able to, from a role-playing perspective, go to a prostitute, get laid, and relieve some of my sanity. Alright, is there anything I missed here? I don't think so. Alright, I'm gonna look around a little bit more here, and I guess I'll record when I see something interesting, because right now it's just kind of like this area is pretty empty. Not a whole lot here. So yeah, I'm gonna probably cut the recording now and start again once I see something that's interesting to see. Well, I got like 2 feet before I saw something interesting. Whoa, Jesus Christ! Oh my God! I knew he was over there, but I didn't think he was gonna be sneaking up on me that quickly. Oh God. So these wolves are fighting this guy. Fuck! Run! Oh God. One shot him? Seriously? Ooh, damn! Boys, we just got lucky. We just got super lucky. It's got an advanced receiver. It's got everything. Long recon scope, compensator, full stock. Doesn't have a recoil compensated stock, but that's fine. Vented barrel. Guys, we just got ridiculously lucky. That's essentially, like, this is essentially our old one, except it's a legendary with poison on it. I will take it. Alright. Totally worth it. You ain't shit, wolf. Hey, stop it. Going. A rad rabbit? A wad wabbit? Right. Rabbit leg. Really? Carrying too much? Definitely want to keep that combat armor piece. This looks like it's kind of fortified over here. Suppose I'll give this a save, and it seems like all of the big like enemies have been legendary so far, which is cool. It gives me a really good chance that I'll get good stuff. Maybe it's just been coincidence, but maybe that's like how it's designed. If so, I'm totally okay with that. Acid, huh? Got me. Another hunter outpost over here, I guess. Let's take a look around here. This is a mining operation, eh? Yes, it is. There's a bed. Maybe we'll get lucky and there'll be all kinds of stuff here we can use. In fact, maybe I'll wait to, look, it's a lit cigar. Maybe I'll wait to really loot this place until after I clear it out and then loot it off camera, and maybe this could be our new home. That'd be really nice if there's, like, stuff to craft with here. So this is going to be like a quarry, I guess. So this is a warehouse. Can't get in that way. Surely, though, you can get in from over here or something. Can I fall through here? Yeah, it works. Here we go, weapons workbench. There's one of the things I want. Hold on, I don't wanna screw myself up here. Alright, so if I do that, still good. If I do that. Let me see here. Full stock. I need a recoil compensating stock. Excuse me, recoil compensating stock, but I don't have the stuff to make one yet. But full stock, it's not that big of a deal. I mean, the recoil is nice to have a better recoil, but the main thing is it has an advanced receiver. So it's a really nice weapon there. Gonna actually dump off. Maybe just that. Actually, I'll probably dump off all of my ranged weapons. I think I can handle taking these guys out. I'm going to dump stuff off there, and I'll come back for it later. I mean, if I do end up using this place... There's a note. If I do end up using this place as a home base, then I'll have to get a lot of stuff from other places. What is this? Northwood Quarry Note 1. I've been tasked to set up explosive charges scattered throughout the quarry to repel another attack. The plan is to set up at least 3 series of explosions. I think I can do more. I'll hook everything up to a button in the main shack's balcony overlooking the center of the quarry. If we're ever attacked, I just need to hit that button and watch the fireworks. Oh, shit. Alright, so, mentioned the center of the quarry. There's a shack overhanging, and apparently you can go over there and blow everything up. There's just a random bear over there. See, I'm going to stealth over here, and the main reason is because I don't want to draw those guys' fire. I wasn't stealthing, was I? There we go, now I'm stealthing. I don't want those guys shooting at me before I get a chance to sneak over there. I feel like I'm justifying myself every time I have to use stealth. I really shouldn't have to. Alright, gotta run through here. I'll loot him later. Gotten three so far. Do I get up there? Hide bundle, I'd assume that's leather. Bandage scissors? Oh, it was a garden gnome. He had the lit cigar in his mouth. Alright, so let's see. Calibrated powerful pipe rifle. I wouldn't mind actually having a pipe rifle if it was like recon scoped. That wouldn't be bad. So they said there should be... Okay, so here's a chem workstation. So far we've got chem and... So far we've got chem, pull hook might be better than this tire iron. But yeah, we've got chem and weapons workbench so far. Oh, here we go. Wow. They all shooting at that dog? Oh my god, I can do it again. Ooh, nice. 45 rounds. Alright, well let's see what else is out here. Ripper might be better, but I don't know. Kind of like the burst damage over sustained. Oh, look at there. We got some eggs. All right, and that goes down into a quarry, it looks like. Of course, there's water here too, which I can just go ahead and drink it, I guess. It'll be dirty, but what the hell? We've already got an infection, so things can't get that much worse. Okay, properly hydrated, excellent. Alright, so, I really blew this place to hell, didn't I? Just heard somebody over there. Another bed here. I really need a cooking workstation somewhere around here. Need a cooking workstation, and I really need a chemistry workstation. Maybe there was already a chemistry workstation, but that's what I need. And this will be a nice place to set up. So cross your fingers. Hopefully we can find those things. Maybe I'll find a mining helmet down in there too. That would be fantastic. I think that's actually pretty likely. All these pipe rifles, but none of them have, none of them have what I'm looking for. None of them have the scope I'm looking for. I can craft a scope, but if I'm gonna craft it, I don't need to carry all those with me. Alright, so, okay, let's go ahead and, jump down inside here and see what we can find. Hopefully we find a mining helmet. Actually, before we do that... Oh, fuck! That's a powerful one. Yeah, that's not happening. Not happening at all. Okay. Oddly, these guys don't spawn when you get close. Normally they would shake to show which ones are the ones that are gonna have mute crabs and which ones are just gonna be eggs. Normally they would kind of shake and you could tell, but you can't see anything here. Yeah, kind of a collapsed structure over here. This leads up. There's nothing up there. And of course over here there's the, well, if I can get up here. Maybe not, just go around. And over here is the entrance. Yeah, I want to see if I could loot that to get that ammo there. Okay, Northridge Quarry. Well, I'll tell you, a mining helmet would be fantastic. It's a lantern there, but that doesn't really do me any good. This place looks super radiated and super scary. I'm sure there's going to be lots of enemies in here. Yes, mining helmet. Now, the only problem is I don't have a gas mask to go with it. Which is not a huge issue down here. But later on, I've got to get a gas mask. Thing is really bright. Almost hurts my eyes to look at it, it's so bright. Yeah, a rough gas mask would be really fantastic right about now. There's a cooking workbench, cooking workstation. sniper rifle there.
Speak to you. Hand your chest to run.
Oh. Yeah, you can't block bullets. Just an FYI, it does not work out well. This looks very promising. So we've got a bed here.
There we go.
Got the weapons workbench. And a cooking station over there as well. There we go, a pipe sniper rifle. That's what I was looking for. So this has pretty much everything I want on it, but this has the scope I need. Now, this should be fairly accurate. Yeah, it is. It's perfectly accurate. It's a scoped weapon, so... Alright, so I'll gather up all my pipe weapons and I'll turn this into something decent then. And I'll have a nice pipe sniper rifle. Because I just... Oh, there's an armor workbench too. Okay, this is perfect. Officially it's perfect, but I need to go outside because I'm taking infection damage. And it's killing me. So yeah, this is great. This will be totally fine. Grab all this water. Ugh, there it was, a straw broke the camel's back. What's this, meat hook might be decent too. I'll see what kind of damage that will do once I mine it out. Alright guys, so I think I'll probably wrap up this episode here. I'm gonna go outside, get healed up, bring all my stuff in here, and we can kind of use this as our kind of new base. The no chem station is not that big of a deal. I don't really make that many chems, and I can always take stuff elsewhere to make chems if I really need to. But I think this will be ideal for our first kind of starter base, and I gotta remember to put my gas mask back on up here. Although, I'm not actually taking rad damage out here. I take it when I go through the fog, but I don't take rad damage out here otherwise, so maybe that's not such a big deal. Actually, you know what? The sun's already set, hasn't it? Yeah, sun has set, so I'm gonna have to sleep through this infection till the sun's back up. Or else I'll just die from an infection. Literally, I'll just die from an infection. I'll have to go and heal up my radiation and stuff on the next day from the sun. So I'm gonna do that, and yeah, next episode. Now we have kind of a home base here. We can take a look over here and explore the rest of this area and start getting into the mainland a bit. Try to explore in there a bit. Alright, thanks so much for watching, guys. I'll see you next time.